Tackling death. There are three types of deaths that we would confront in our lifetime. Death of a near and dear one, where we get bereaved. Death of a patient, which we need to handle. And our own final destination. Today is the 3rd of November 2018, and I take you back 28 years, where exactly at this time, a young man, 28 years younger, had just returned after cremating the person who gave birth to him 27 years earlier. He passed away 6:30 in the morning, and around 10 o'clock, I was back home. Things looked difficult. I had spent the best of my times with him, but I realized over the last 10 years that we spent together that it was time for him to let go. He was giving up, yet holding on and stagnating. And finally, 3rd of November, 1990, 6:30 in the morning, he let go and moved on. I've spent more than my life with him, without him today, with a lot of fear. False evidence appearing real for the future. Anxiety, which at times shakes me up. But what I learned on that day was that we should let go and move on. I have taken that leap of faith, and I believe that I was right. Because if you think of something, then you know it is right. It only happens when you start believing in it. Most people, especially orthopedic surgeons, look at evidence, and we strongly say that seeing is believing. I am one of those who believes and sees that. If you believe something, you start seeing it. If you go into the Bhagavad Gita, it always says that the body is temporary, just a set of clothes that you're taking off. And Atma Amar Hai, the soul persists. We should not fear death, especially of our near and dear ones. And if you have been empathetic, compassionate towards your patients, they also would challenge you and would at times include you as their family member. Death of a patient should be looked at just as you look at the death of a near and dear one. You should feel bereaved, hold on for a short period of time, but let go. We as doctors can be godly, never God. Whatever is happening through us. We are ultimately instruments of a much bigger force. There will be a lot of grief, a lot of unhappiness, and at that time, the best thing to do is remain silent. Remain silent and don't just look but see. Don't just touch but feel. Don't just hear but listen. This is where empathy takes over, and you should not be just sympathetic. You have to move from joga jog to sanjog, from connection to compassion, something which is beyond what we are doing, which is kriya, to a stage of karma. Communication happens only in silence. We have to remain silent and connected to the patient and the family. We have to do it. And at this stage, you have to follow the prayer which was made so popular by Reinhold Niebuhr. It's called the Serenity Prayer. It says, God, grant me the serenity to accept the things I cannot change, courage to change the things that I can, and wisdom to know the difference. Change what can be changed, accept what cannot be changed, and rise above what is not acceptable. You have to become like an eagle, fly over the clouds whenever there is that monsoon and thunderstorm lingering. And if you do that, when the entire wheel comes back to you, you would be happy facing that transformation, a situation where each one of us would be knocking on the doors of that part where we came from. I have a vision of myself passing away. I would love to be in my shoes, speaking to my colleagues, and go away on that eternal journey. This is what I feel I would love to have for myself. I would do it forever, never quit. If at some stage I let go, it'll be fine, but I won't give up. I have always found it difficult to change, but change is inevitable. You have to take a decision whether you walk away or you continue trying harder. At times we get stuck, whether it's with illness, whether it's with a job, whether it's with a bad marriage. But remember, the happiest moments in life are when you find the courage to let go of what you cannot change. And when you go, leave a legacy which you would be proud of. You have to leave this world better than it was when you came in. When you were born, you cried and the world rejoiced. Do something so that when you die, you laugh, you rejoice, and the world cries. Ladies and gentlemen, we all start unknown. But please remember, we should finish unforgettable. Abandon all the attachment which you may have to any form of action, and that's when you will attain peace. Please remember, what belongs to you today belonged to someone else yesterday and will belong to somebody else tomorrow. This is the law of the universe. I'm sure that you may love me or hate me after this presentation on death. We can discuss it over a cup of coffee. If you love me, I'll be with you forever because I'll be a part of your heart. And if you hate me, I'll be there for longer because I'll be on your mind forever. Thank you very much for a patient hearing.